ma breathe, and I see a dad, and run away. Bible says, yes, we still can send me, say, oh, my baby. And then that's it, she, oh, that's her, sorry. But we are one cut as a mother. Was sorry, and I am sorry, dad. And I'm not paying the better enemy, I don't know, and I'll come up for the beer, and we'll be around. And my page is ready. Sanda aduko pende radinko chuma ya manu da danka sa obe peja no na bible ama matcha sida sa ayeyi kosura e radin san ne nyi nyam enemi ya gero kone ya sori radin ena no pe ha da bro sibranda la bo shahata oh Jesus you are wonderful, you deserve all the glory, you deserve all the honor. Me pare ene wa kuma ene sore rade da ma bre me pare ene wa kuma ene tontu me rade da ma bre bebi e wo biara peje rade ni din kanfo no kokro no nanya bonia ya nanya tia fo ena no pai ba ze tele bagado sta ba da bra da bo bebre ne ene wo kwa da yo ma ti ya san ni mo na so bebre ne wo fo ka o pa wa san na ba am na wo ya kwa ya san na ba ah so ke sika ka ye ni bi Aka hunya dia kayenyi bi obi twane hen esu da mabri our head be wanu tuntun erade da mabri habo sibiria ndala bo sabaria ndala bo ade de bo sibada bo shabada brada bo sa oh Jesus oh tsumino wedia sa
Hey!
Nyamia. Ayo Nyamia. Naya Padala.
Servant, Reverend Pius B. Gayton, bring you the message of the gospel this morning. Wherever you are under the sound of my voice, I just want you to stay glued to your television set, even as the word of God comes forth in all simplicity and with power. Pick up your phone, tell a friend to tell a friend. A time in his presence is erring. Crystal clear, life and colored, here on Ideas GH TV, the best TV online station in the Western region. Hallelujah. I just want you to begin to worship the Lord. Just thank the Lord for another opportunity. Just thank the Lord for life. Thank the Lord for grace. Thank Him for His mercy. Today is Easter Sunday. As a matter of fact, lockdown Easter, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Whatever the Lord does, He has a purpose. He has a reason for whatever He does. He locked us down so that he will release us together with his son Jesus Christ victoriously in resurrection. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You shout amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Turn your Bibles with me to the book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter number 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. We are reading from verse 1 to 5.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 1 to 5. And I, brethren, when I came to you.
And I, brethren, when I came to you.
Come not with excellency of speech.
I came not with the excellency of speech.
Or of wisdom.
Or of wisdom.
Declaring unto you.
Declaring unto you.
The testimony of God.
The testimony of God.
For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ him crucified and I was with you in weakness and in fear
and in much trembling
and my speech and my preaching
was not with enticing words of man's wisdom
but in demonstration of the spirit and of power that your faith should not stand in the wisdom.
Should not stand in the wisdom of man.
But in the power of God.
But in the power of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, we are reading a scripture that was written by the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul, as we know, was an ordained apostle of God. One that was elected of God. Before he was called Saul, he was someone who was known for persecuting the saints of God. But the Lord arrested Paul on his way to Damascus to arrest some Christians and to persecute them. When the Lord arrested Paul, the Apostle Paul, who before was destroying everything that belonged unto God, now became a strong servant and a follower of our Lord Jesus Christ. And it came to pass that Paul went to the Grecian city of Corinth. And from the scripture that we just read, Paul tells us that when he went to Corinth, he did not go to the people of Corinth with the excellency of words, with wisdom. He did not go to speak with power. He did not go to express any form of pride to the believers who at the time were at Corinth. And beloved, I just want you to know that the city of Corinth, as it is noted, is a cosmopolitan city that did not actually believe the power of the cross. Corinth was a city that did not believe the Lord Jesus Christ. And so when Paul went there, one thing that Paul was clear about his going there was that he did not determine to know anything amongst them. He did not determine to know anything amongst them. He did not determine to know about anything but save one thing, Jesus Christ and him crucified. Now, there are some three things that I want you to note from the scripture that we read.
The scripture reveals three things. Number one, it reveals the mission of Paul. Number two, it reveals the message of Paul. And then number three, it reveals the mandate of Paul. Praise the Lord. From the verse 1, we are made aware. To the verse 2, we are made aware by the Apostle Paul that when he came to Corinth, when he came to the believers in Corinth, he did not determine to know anything amongst them. He did not determine to know who and who was rich and who was poor. He did not determine to know who and who has been to the university, has been to Harvard, has been to Yale, has been to Cambridge. He did not determine to know who and who have built a house. He did not determine to know who and who have bought cars. He did not determine to know anything. But Paul was determined to know one thing. He was determined to know Jesus Christ and him crucified. Whether Jesus Christ is made known to them or not. Whether they know the Christ who was crucified on the cross. That was the decision of Paul. That was the mission of Paul for going to Corinth. Praise the Lord. This morning, I want you to listen to me and listen to me crystal clear. That we are not here this morning to determine whether you have certificates or you don't have certificates. Whether you have gone to school or you have not gone to school. We are not determined to know anything, whether you are poor or you are rich. We are not determined to know anything about your possession. We are determined to know whether you have Jesus Christ and him crucified inside of your spirit. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The second thing about the Apostle Paul, that he said, Jesus Christ crucified is the person that he determined to know. And that was the message of Jesus Christ. That was the message of Paul to the people of Corinth. The message of the Apostle Paul to the people of Corinth. The message that he carried to them. The message that he sent to them. He did not send them the prosperity message. He did not send them the message of healing. But he sent them the message of Jesus Christ and him crucified. Hallelujah. He sent them the message of Jesus Christ and him crucified. That 2,000 years ago, there was a man called Jesus Christ who was born by the Virgin Mary. And Jesus Christ was the King of the Jews. He was faultless. He was blameless. He didn't do any sin. He didn't do any evil. But the people hated him. And even his own people, people from his own household, they hated him. They hated him to the extent that they casted him to be crucified. He was arrested by Pontius Pilate. The people casted thorns upon him. A crown of thorn was placed upon him. They slapped him left and right. They booted him. They spat into his nose. They spat into his eyes. They spat into his mouth. And Jesus Christ was maltreated. Jesus Christ was treated as though somebody who was a sinner. He was treated as though somebody who has committed treason. He was treated as though somebody who had done so great an evil. But my Lord, Jesus Christ, had done virtually nothing. Jesus Christ had done virtually nothing. Jesus Christ had done virtually nothing. And Jesus Christ, after he was released to be killed, he was hung on the cross of Calvary. He was hung on the cross. He was hung on the cross. And on the cross, my Jesus tested. He tested. He tested. He tested, he tested, and at long last he gave the ghost and said that it is finished. Wherever you are under the sound of my voice, this morning I declare to you, the Lord is telling me to tell you, that it is finished. The Lord is telling me to tell you that your problems are over because of his death, because of his burial, because of his resurrection. He tells me to tell you that your problems are over. If only you can put your faith in this Jesus Christ. If only you can trust Jesus. If only you can lean on Jesus Christ, your problems shall be over. But may I ask you, this Jesus that I'm talking about, do you know him? Have you accepted him? Has he come to be seated in your heart? Paul said, I didn't come determining to know anything amongst you, save Jesus Christ and him crucified. Beloved, want to know, have you Jesus Christ inside of your spirit? This Jesus Christ was crucified. Look at him on the cross. Look at him shedding blood for you. Look at him shedding blood for you. Look at him dying slowly. Not because he has sinned. Not because he has gone wrong. But because you have sinned. Because you have sinned. He died on the cross for you and for me. That by his death, we might be saved. That by his death, we might be saved. Jesus has died. Jesus was buried. Jesus went to hell. He took the keys of death and he took the keys of hell. He didn't die forever. He came out victoriously. He came out triumphantly. Jesus Christ is alive. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is alive. He is alive forevermore. He is alive forevermore.
Amen.
He is alive forevermore.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. He is alive. Amen. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Amen. He's alive. Amen. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Amen. He is risen. Amen. He is risen. Jesus is risen, forever he is risen, amen. Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Beloved in Christ, if only you can put your faith in Jesus, if only you can trust Jesus, if only you can believe in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. You shall resurrect. You shall resurrect.
Amen.
You shall resurrect from defeat.
Amen.
You shall resurrect from your sickness.
Amen.
You shall resurrect from poverty.
Amen.
You shall resurrect from any problem that is confronting your life. If only you can fix your focus on Jesus Christ. Let's see what the scripture says in 1 Corinthians chapter number 15 and the verse of 14. 19 and 20. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, what is there is that it is telling us that in Jesus Christ that we are talking about, if he was not risen from the dead, then our faith in the resurrection of the dead was in vain. If Jesus Christ had not risen from the dead, then our faith in the resurrection, that when we die, believing in Christ, would have been in vain. But Jesus Christ didn't remain in his grave. He arose from the dead. He arose triumphantly from the dead. If only our hope, if only our faith was in Jesus Christ, and Jesus went to the cross and he was buried and he didn't awake again. The Bible said in the verse 20, it says, those of us who believe in Jesus Christ, we were the most miserable people of all people. If Christians today who believe in Jesus Christ, if Jesus didn't rise up from the dead, we were the most miserable of all people. But thank God, Jesus didn't remain in the grave. Thank God Jesus arose from the dead. Thank God Jesus is alive this morning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I declare to you under the sound of my voice, may you arise from the dead.
Amen.
Anything that is holding onto you, anything that is pulling you down, anything that is sitting upon your life, anything that has brought defeat to you, anything that brought sickness to you,
Jesus,
anything that has brought any kind of catastrophe, anything that has made you mercilessly down, I declare to you, resurrect now.
Amen.
Resurrect now.
Amen.
May you experience
Amen.
The resurrecting power of Jesus. May you experience
Amen.
The resurrecting power of Jesus
Amen.
In your finances. Receive
Amen.
The resurrecting power of Jesus
Amen.
In your business. Receive the resurrecting power of Jesus
Amen.
In your body. Receive the resurrecting power of Jesus.
Amen.
When you resurrect with Jesus Christ, your life shall be glorious. May your life be glorious.
Amen.
May your life be glorious.
Amen.
May your life be glorious.
Amen.
May your life stench with the aroma of God's glory. In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
May you be the first and not the last. May you be above only and not beneath. May you progress and not retrogress. May you increase and not decrease. May you prosper in everything that you do, because Christ is risen. Christ is risen with you. Christ is risen with me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the final thing that Paul talks about, the final thing about Paul is that Paul had a mandate. His mandate was to turn the people from darkness to light. His mandate was to turn the unbelievers to believe in the Jesus Christ that we are talking about here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning, wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, I am recommending Jesus to you. I am recommending Jesus to you. The mandate of Paul was to turn the people from darkness. This morning, I am recommending Jesus Christ to you. If you do not know Jesus, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ, this is the time to accept Jesus. He died for you. He died for you. He died for you. And the Bible said, and as many who do believed him, he gave them power to become the children of God. If you believe in Jesus Christ this morning, you become the child of God. If you believe in Jesus Christ this morning, you become the saint of God. And behold, when the Lord appears in his glory, in the clouds, you'll be among those who are going to be raptured into the air. You'll be among those who are going to be raptured into the air. Praise the Lord. You'll be among those who are going to be raptured to meet the Lord in the skies. But if you have not accepted the Lord, if you are not giving your life to Christ, if you are not giving your faith to Christ, the verse 5 of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, it tells us, so that we will not put our faith in the wisdom of man, so that our faith will not dwell in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. What is the power of God here talking about? It is talking about the cross. The cross of Jesus is the power of God. The Bible said, to those that are perishing, to those that has lost, the preaching of the gospel is foolishness to them. My dear brother, my dear sister, do you see the preaching of the gospel foolishness to you? Do you see the message of the gospel foolishness to you? Do you see that Jesus Christ crucified is foolishness to you? There are some people who say that Jesus didn't die. When he was under the cross, some people came and removed him from the cross. Then he came, they treated him, he became alive. And then he went to a place like Saudi Arabia. He went and settled there. He got a wife for himself. And then he began to produce children. So Jesus Christ went and settled somewhere and he met life. They don't believe that Jesus Christ died. This morning, are you one of those people? God is telling you this morning that if you believe that Christ died for you, if you believe that Christ resurrected from the dead, then even though you die, yet shall you resurrect again. Even if you die today in the physical body, You resurrect again the second time. Praise the Lord. And you will not be dead forever. You, because you have eternal life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you have eternal life. He said that our faith will not be in man. Our faith will not be in the wisdom of man. But our faith will be in the power of God. Just fix your gaze on the cross that Jesus Christ died on. Fix your gaze on the cross. Just look at the cross. Just look at the cross and ponder within your heart that you cannot save yourself without the cross of Jesus Christ. The cross is symbolic of power. The cross is symbolic of the power of God. Because of the cross, sicknesses are broken. Because of the cross, sicknesses are destroyed. Because of the cross, the devil is destroyed. Because of the cross, the works of the enemy is destroyed. I recommend Jesus to you. I recommend Jesus to you. Hallelujah. If you are not accepted Jesus Christ, I want you to pray this prayer after me. Just pray this prayer after me. Say, dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Thank you for your word.
Thank you for your word.
That has come forth to me.
That has come forth to me.
In all simplicity.
In all simplicity.
I accept that.
I accept that.
I have sinned against you.
I have sinned against you.
I cannot save myself. Therefore, I need you to come into my heart, to forgive my sins, to cleanse my sins, to wash my sins, and to declare me whole. Write my name in the book of life, so that when you appear in your glory, I'll be part of your sins. Dear Lord Jesus, today that you have resurrected, today being Easter Sunday, let the resurrection power of yours come upon me. May I resurrect in glory. May I resurrect in power. May I resurrect in finances. May I resurrect in my business. May I resurrect in my Christian life. May my life be stinking with glory. May my life be an epitome of your glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for covering us with the blood of Jesus. Precious one, I soak you into the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord protect you.
Amen.
The Lord guide you.
Amen.
The Lord cover you.
Amen.
Until the same time, they come your way again. Continue to stay in grace and be secure in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord bless you. Bye-bye.